So what did we miss? Well, in the very beginning of this class, we took a brief trip to visit some native Canadian singers. Now, having been all over the world, I'm going to take you back to the top of the globe, to the region of Europe known as Scandinavia. So pack your coats, because this is going to be a chilly journey.
Scandinavia is a subregion of Europe that consists of Norway, Sweden, and Denmark. It's a beautiful area known for its landscapes and its long, dark winters. In the northern parts of Norway and Sweden, the sun doesn't rise for months. Today, we will be looking at the music of the native people of the region. You may know them by their older, more commonly used name, the Laplanders, but recently, we have shifted to calling them what they call themselves, the Sami. For a long time, the Sami people's way of life was centered around one thing, reindeer herding.
A nomadic people, the Sami moved together in groups of families that herded hundreds of reindeer. They used the animals for food, clothing, and shelter. In modern times, some of the Sami people still remain reindeer herders, but many live in modern housing with normal jobs.
Those who remain herders, instead of traveling miles by foot, herd the deer by means of helicopters and walkie-talkies. Like too many other indigenous people groups, the Sami were forced to assimilate to the surrounding culture, and much of their own culture was suppressed. This included their traditional singing style, that of Yoiking, which was considered sinful by the Christian culture that dominated the area.
As the Sami people are becoming increasingly well-known, their style of singing, the Yoik, has become a sign of identity to them. Yoiks can have lyrics, but more often are wordless and improvised on the spur of the moment, an expression of the feelings within, especially those spurred by self-reflection or the beauty of the natural world. This beautiful example, titled Yoik of the Wind, is one of the Sami people's wordless yoiks. Whether this one was handed down from generations past or was improvised on the spot is not known, but I think it is safe to say that either way, one can still hear the passion for nature that inspires this exquisite genre of music.
There was no gender restriction on who could yoik in ancient Sami society. Men and women alike yoiked whenever the feeling took them. Furthermore, the tradition of yoiking is so old that we have no idea where it got its roots. The legends of the Sami say that the fairies and the elves gifted the Sami their first yoiks. Ethnomusicologists have said that yoiking is, quote, one of the oldest continuous musical traditions in Europe, unquote.
Besides being inspired by nature, yoiks are often dedicated to individuals, and when performed, evoke that individual. In the same way that one does not paint about a bird, but rather paints a bird, the Sami say that one does not yoik about a person, but rather yoiks that person. The yoik itself is a copy rather than a description. And now, as the Sami culture continues to grow and be recognized by modern society, the yoik has come to be a signature of that culture and a rebellion against colonization. And while many people still have not heard of the Sami people or yoiking, their culture has begun to influence movies, music, and literature that centers around the region of Scandinavia. Now I'm sure, or at least I hope, that a few of you are thinking, this is so cool, I've never heard this kind of music before. But the truth is, you probably have. A yoik was used in a very famous movie set in Norway. As it happens, Disney does, on occasion, take account for the indigenous people of the region,
and this familiar soundtrack is original Sami Yoiking, written by a Sami singer-songwriter for this film. Furthermore, in Frozen 2, Disney reached out to the Sami people, and they came to an agreement. In return for the Sami contributing more about their culture and lifestyle, Disney translated Frozen 2 into North Sami for them. The way the Northuldra dress, live, and their nomadic way of life in Frozen 2 is based almost entirely on Sami culture. So, with all that said, I couldn't resist the chance at getting a few friends together and doing some traditional Sami yoiking. So please enjoy Yuhaili.
No.